Hi guys, how are you? So this particular video is for a lot of inquiries or interest I was getting from a lot of graduates in India who are pursuing BDS, like second year, third year, final years, interns, that what should they do during their graduation, unko aisa kya karna chahiye apne BDS mein, so that they can, you know, make their path easier if they want to move abroad once they finish their BDS. So what I'm going to tell you today, that what I feel at this age and after the experience and after moving here in Canada, that what you should do when you are in BDS and you have already planned that you want to move out. See, first thing is, when you are preparing, that you are sure that after your internship you want to move out, and it's a very good option, but you have to, you know, judge yourself. First thing you should do is, whenever you are studying in your graduation in India, refer to standard textbooks, okay, and try to understand the concept. Try to build your concepts. There's no point just revising 10 years of papers and just going for the exam and clearing the exam. That is one thing. But if you have a bigger goal to move abroad, my first point to you is, refer standard textbooks, try to understand them. If you're having difficulty understanding them, ask for help from your faculty, from friends, from seniors, and try to understand it. Okay, today you have good options on the internet also. You can go and understand it. But then, you know, you have to give it time. It cannot be without extra efforts. But because you're starting right from your first year or second year or your third year, it becomes easy when you try to move out, because when there are exams in other countries like US or Canada or any other place, these are all the same questions from those standard texts. So if you have done already the standard text, it will be better and it will be easier for you to clear the exam and make a future. Second thing about, you know, what you should do in your graduation if you are planning to move abroad, you should start using a loop and a light. Whichever company, whichever suits you, whichever is financially feasible to you. But there is no university rule throughout the country which says that you cannot use a good loop and a good light during your exams in the university, like your third year exam or your second year exam or your final year exam. So my advice to you is, when you get into preclinics, especially the preclinical operator, start using a loop and a light. It's a very good investment, because when you come for exams in countries like Canada or US, you have to use those magnification and illumination equipments. So it might appear to you that it's expensive, but if you have future plans, don't shy away from it. I'm sure none of the faculty will stop you, and they will be glad if you do it. But the cost of it, you have to bear. So buy a loop, buy a light when you start your second year. It's okay if you have missed it in second year, even if in third year, final year, start getting used to it. Because most of the clinical exams happen on the typhoons in US or in Canada, and you are supposed to use loops and lights. So please do that. Third point I would say, that plan ahead. Plan way ahead. Don't take it lightly. These countries are 1 year ahead. So if you apply for an admission in 2020, you have to apply in 2019. If you want admission in 2021, you have to apply in 2020. And there's a lot of paperwork involved. And I'm telling you that the paperwork out here is not slow, but the paperwork back home is very slow. So you have to take care of that. And finally, I would say that the financial thing. Yes, it's an expensive process. The tickets are expensive. The exams are expensive. The English exam is expensive. Yes, and one good point. You have to be good with your English to move to these countries. So prepare your English well. If you're in first year, if you're in second year, read English newspapers, read English texts, watch English movies, watch English serials. But not just that, okay? Study as well, okay? Just don't do that. But improve your English, because everywhere, even when you apply for your immigration, when you apply for your university, when you apply for the job, your English result is considered. And how good you are in English, when you talk, when you use the language, is important. So these three things. So to conclude this video, I'll say, if you are a BDS graduate in India and you want to move abroad right from first year, second year, first thing, improve your English. Second thing, refer to standard text. Okay, give good time, understand the concepts. Third thing, when you're working in clinics, pre-clinics, use a light and loop. Okay. Fourth thing, talk to your mentors, talk to your seniors, talk to your staff, talk to your faculty, and get your questions cleared. Okay, don't shy away from it. And finally, it is an expensive process. So plan ahead if you want to move out. If you don't have the money, I can understand. Tell your parents that after 4 years, I might be needing 10 lakhs or 5 lakhs or 20 lakhs, whatever you want. Or you move on a student visa abroad. Okay. So in conclusion, plan it ahead. Refer to standard text. Use lights and loops. And improve your English. I wish you best of luck. And this video is specifically for the graduates who have doubt through their graduation and they want to move out. Thank you guys for listening to me. Please do like and subscribe. I don't know how does it matter, but it's okay. And right now, this is a wonderful view of the bay in San Francisco. So I hope you like it. And I hope you all get your dreams come true. Best of luck.